In the early part of the 20th century, with racial segregation still in place in much of the U.S., black filmmakers made movies for black audiences outside the white Hollywood mainstream. They produced around 500 so-called race films, but most are lost to history.
Newly mastered from archival film elements.
To preserve America's first independent cinema, this year the company Kino Lorber released a five-disc collection combining 20 hours of these films called The Pioneers of African American Cinema. The collection of 16 feature films and shorts, mainly from the 1920s and 30s, includes comedies, dramas, and documentaries. They not only starred black actors, the films were often written, directed, and produced by African Americans. Executive producer Paul Miller, a musician also known as DJ Spooky, raised money for the project, initially through a Kickstarter campaign.
And I'd like to ask you to help us out.
We helped them raise a little bit under maybe $100,000, just, you know, in a couple, like, a week and some change. And I love to think of it as a festival in a box.
So the New York Times called this project, this is what it said about it, from the perspective of cinema history and American history, for that matter, there has never been a more significant video release. So why is this collection so significant?
Well, the interesting thing about American history is we have what I call selective amnesia. And Americans love to forget, like, people, what Korean War? Did we ever occupy the Philippines? So putting the box set together was kind of a situation of reclaiming these hidden histories of very positive and pro, what I call multicultural visions of this history of American cinema, which is usually, again, very whitewashed.
How revolutionary was it at that time that these films were actually able to get made and seen?
You gotta remember, it was incredible that African Americans saw themselves on the screen. Usually most portrayals of African Americans in the larger white culture were meant to be very derogatory. So by reclaiming that space in the culture, you could show positive images of black people outside of the white context.
Miller says mainstream movies portrayed African Americans, often by whites in blackface, as unintelligent and bumbling or evil, dangerous villains. By contrast, in the African-American-made race films, black characters were often heroic, intelligent, and romantic. Teachers, detectives, cowboys, roles Hollywood reserved for whites. Take the earliest film in the box set, the 1915 slapstick comedy Two Nights of Vaudeville. In the 11-minute short, the two main characters find theater tickets and end up in the best seats in the house, which would have been for whites.
At that time, it must have been shocking and wild, and must have also been very tickling to the audience, and people must have thought it was hilarious. So it was a real treasure to find that one.
The Blood of Jesus from 1941 is a deeply religious film about a woman on her deathbed who's having a crisis of faith. Shot on location in Texas, it was written and directed by Spencer Williams, who also starred in the film. The Blood of Jesus was one of the most successful race movies ever made and was added to the National Film Registry at the Library of Congress in 1991. So was that kind of film just non-existent at the time?
Those kind of portrayals of African Americans within the context of spirituality, as within the context of a positive vision of community and religiosity, they weren't around.
The set also contains nine films by director Oscar Michaud, a one-time Pullman train porter turned self-taught prolific filmmaker.
Oscar Michaud was mostly considered to be the foundation DNA of African-American cinema because, again, he was independent. He dealt with topics and themes that were directly related to black experiences and with a powerful statement.
Michaud tackled issues like racism, lynchings, interracial relationships, and poverty from a black perspective. His films were often a direct response to the earlier monumental film by D.W. Griffith, The Birth of a Nation, which negatively portrayed blacks and glorified the Ku Klux Klan. By contrast, Michaud's Within Our Gates from 1920, the earliest surviving feature film directed by an African American, the heroine is a mixed-race woman named Sylvia, who goes to the North to raise money for a school for poor black children in the South.
In Within Our Gates, the mixed-race character really is viewed as a warm and supportive person. In Birth of a Nation, a mixed race person is viewed as betraying both races. The mulatto, the mixed race person, is a schemer. They're fooling the whites and they're using the blacks. And the idea of being biracial or multiracial was viewed as a kind of a disruption of the established order.
What kind of role do you see the films in this collection playing in America today within this context?
I think post-2016 election, we really need to all take some perspective about racial politics and the anxiety of different segments of the population about being left behind, or lower income whites who, one could argue, the election was about their economic anxieties. On the other hand, with African American culture, after seeing an 8 years of an African American president, we also need to understand that there's been a long history of positive images of African Americans. So the box set is more important than ever, precisely because it looks at the archive. And many of these films were lost, many of these films were difficult to find, and by restoring them and putting them in a box set, one place, one stop shop, I think it gives people a powerful tool to look at the history of cinema, again, not just African American, but overall.